I want you to welcome Cody Channel.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming and being with us today.
I'm so happy to be here.
So, Cody, I want to start off with sharing a little bit about yourself. Besides all the things that you do, you know, I want to hear about you.
Okay, well, so I basically started doing healing work when I was about 5. I was encountered and, well, surrounded by these very dark beings and a lot of very serious astral projections and different realities that I used to escape my childhood trauma. So
when you were 5?
Yeah, so from a very young age, that was like my earliest memory, but I think it was even before that.
Did you know that you were doing healings and work and that? Or like, I mean, or were you thinking that you were talking to your imaginary friends?
I was just very, at the time, I was very afraid, and then I would have moments of being touched by these beautiful lights that let me know that I was always going to be safe and that everything was part of a plan. So I studied all kinds of different astrology aspects and really got into reading all about the Pleiadians and the different alien races and the different healing modalities to really heal your childhood trauma. So that was where it all began as far as my life as a healer. I moved to LA in 2013.
Okay.
And by then I became a certified Reiki master a little bit shortly after and started with Reiki and would always start each session with an astrology reading, which most of my clients thought was interesting because that wasn't what they were used to. But I felt that astrology really grounds you. I really got into the houses because each house represents a different stage of your life, pretty much. It starts with self as the first house and goes all the way to spirit as the 12th house. I just think it's important to see an astrologer because I think there's so many people that are just sort of like doing the horoscopes or doing very surface memes or this and that. And I do believe in the power of really diving in and really taking a good look at your soul map.
Well, yeah. And I mean, and it makes a difference. Like, I think one of the criticisms that a lot of people have towards astrology is how does every single person fit in one of 12, you know, people, right? You know,
right.
And we're not all having one of 12 days. But when you're getting into looking at all of these different houses and all of the different aspects and how each individual person is going to have their own individual map.
Yeah.
Well, now you're talking about massive variety.
And then there's like 500,000 asteroids, right? So there's a lot of asteroids that we study that are more popular, but you could go in and you could really chart in any asteroid if you wanted to.
Wow.
That exists. People will come to find that their name is in a really important place if their name is in an asteroid. And everything has so much energy, right? Not as intense as the planets, but there's just this great web of energy just divinely guiding you and supporting you.
And now, is there any way to see, or do you do sometimes predictive chart readings of knowing what's to come, or?
Oh, yes. My go-to planets for predictive are the North and South nodes, which I haven't talked about, and Jupiter.
Okay.
So Jupiter moves every year into a new sign and a new house for most people's charts.
Okay.
So Jupiter and the North Node. So, for example, this year, the North Node's in Cancer and the South Node's in Capricorn.
Okay.
So the North Node being in Cancer this year is really showing us collectively that we are going to be unlocking and unleashing our emotions. Yes, so I have healgood.love is my website.
Cute.
Yeah, I do. I really am community-minded, and I like to do a lot of one-on-one healings, but I also love for when couples come to me, or a mother and daughter, or just any kind of friend group even. I do a lot of group things here as well. I'll be doing things, and you can find me at Heal Good. You can find me on the Liberate website. I do have a YouTube channel, and it's Cody Channel. Instagram, Cody Channel. And
all those,
you'll find me all around. I'm starting a project right now where we're volunteering with getting a lot of funding for Skid Row.
Oh, beautiful.
And so we're kind of partnering up with a few different places, giving women without access to these tools once a month a women's group with like big care packages and different healing modalities.
If you enjoyed this conversation, like it, subscribe, and share it with your friends. If you want some more amazing resources on your path of liberation, head over to liberateyourself.com and sign up for our mailing list. Connect with us on Facebook, Instagram, at Liberate Hollywood, all one word, or Liberate Emporium, all one word. Until next time, liberate yourself.